Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about critical listening environments. People are really starting to understand now that the room is a system composed of parts. It's taken years for us to get that message across, but I think we're starting to see some improvement in that area. So it's really a system or a space that we create with individual parts that act as a system, okay? It's a critical listening. We want to hear everything, both the good and the bad in the recording. Now I'm going to assume, you know, a two-channel playback system here for purposes of this illustration. So we got the gear, right? 50% is gear, but 50% of our sound is room. You know, that's going to equal 100% of what we hear. And that's really what's important, right? Hopefully it is. I mean, if we're going to go through all this, all these issues, we want to make sure that that's our ultimate goal. We want a low noise floor. We want the room, obviously, as quiet as we can get it all the time, you know. We have rooms in the 30 dB SPL range that we've designed. So we can dial it in. The point is everything can be designed for. So that's what we have to do up front. We have to, you know, set all these design goals, and then we work towards those and apply the associated costs. It's a step-by-step process. Two-channel playback, like I said. You spent the money on the gear. You spent a lot of time. I know guys that spend months, years on that stuff. I used to too. I get it. But you only spent time on half the problem. The other half is the room. It's even probably bigger than 50, but we won't get into that discussion. That's just another waste of time. So human beings are big time wasters sometimes. Suffice it to say, if we can agree on this kind of balance, you got to treat the room, right? 25K average. I went back and looked at our sales over the last 17 years. That's about what's average to get a CLE. Now that's 80% resolution. We still have 20% problem. We can go higher. Mastering rooms, for example, want 90%. Mixed rooms are pretty happy with 8. Most two-channel playbacks are pretty happy with 80. But if you want higher, we can get higher, just more money, right? More budget, more space. You can't leave 50% on the table. You spend all this time and money on 50%, so you got another 50% left. You can't leave that on the table. You got to go after it. And there's your cost, okay? Low frequency treatment first, mids and high seconds if you have to stage it. Try not to. Try to come up with the whole budget. Nice thing about our process, if we're building the units for you, we only need a 50% deposit on your order. We're about 4.5, 5 months out on new orders. So that gives you 5 months to get the other half. So that'll help with your cash flow. So think about that, because that's where we're at. This is our busiest time of the year now. Don't forget, there's three sound fields. What do we got? We got width, we got height, and we got length. So we have three sound fields, three treatment types. Well, not necessarily three treatment types, but different amount surface area coverage on each treatment. You got to address each of those three sound fields separately. Critical listening environment. Hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that, because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple of days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.